Chapter 9, Mishnah 3. The previous Mishnah taught that Eretz Yisrael is divided into three provinces with regards to the laws of beer, and that each of those provinces are subdivided into three regions. Our Mishnah explains why that Mishnah did not simply say that there are nine regions. We now turn to the words of the Mishnah. And why did the sages say three lands? Since each province is divided into three regions, there is in fact a total of nine lands. The sages specified three lands in order to teach that we may continue eating produce in any one province until the last of that species disappears from all three regions of that province. However, if it could still be found in one region of the province, we may continue eating it in the other regions in that province, because a province is treated as a single unified area in regard to beer, despite the fact that it can be divided into smaller regions. Thus, in practice, there are only three lands, i.e. the three provinces. The next Tana takes a different approach. Rabbi Shimon says, they spoke of three lands with regard to Judea. That is, when the sages mentioned three lands, they were referring to the three different regions of Judea: the mountains of Judea, the lowlands of Judea, and the valley of Judea. Each of those regions is a separate area in regard to beer. But all the other provinces of Eretz Yisrael, namely Galilee and the west side of the Jordan, have the same beer deadline as the mountains of the king, the mountainous region of Judea. The Mishnah states two exceptions to the rules taught thus far. And all the lands of Eretz Yisrael are as one with respect to olives and dates. We may eat either of those two species as long as it could still be found anywhere in Eretz Yisrael, because the entire country is deemed one area in this respect.